Welcome to this MP36PH-3C diesel-electric locomotive in Caltrain livery. This brief introduction will cover basic driving controls, passenger door operation, and recovery from an emergency stop. Climb aboard to get started. A lot of time will be spent in the engineer's seat. These trains operate a semi-fast service pattern and thus do not stop at all stations on the line. Be sure to only stop where indicated. Activate the auxiliary systems as indicated. To confirm this locomotive in the train is in charge of the brake systems, set the cut-in control. This locomotive has a removable reverser. This must be inserted before setting the direction of travel. Take a quick glance at the platform to ensure all is safe, then unlock the doors. It's time to depart. Set the doors to locked. When fully releasing the brakes, wait until the brake cylinder gauge has stopped moving before applying the throttle. When using the throttle to increase power, do so slowly to provide a comfortable ride for passengers. Use the throttle and brake levers to ensure the line speed limit is adhered to. take a quick glance at the platform to ensure all is safe, then unlock the doors. Passengers boarded, proceed to the next station. Be aware that before arriving there, an emergency stop will be simulated. To recover from this situation, the controls must first be reset. Follow the indicated steps. The train is ready to move again. Continue on to the next station. Practice makes perfect. Take a quick glance at the platform to ensure all is safe, then unlock the doors. Good work. That concludes this introduction. More details on the operation of this train can be found in the manual. Welcome to this Bombardier bi-level cab car in Caltrain livery. This brief introduction will cover basic driving controls, passenger door operation, and recovery from an emergency stop. Climb aboard to get started. A lot of time will be spent in the engineer's seat. These trains operate a semi-fast service pattern and thus do not stop at all stations on the line. Be sure to only stop where indicated. To confirm this vehicle in the train is in charge of the brake systems, set the cut-in control. This vehicle has a removable reverser. This must be inserted before setting the direction of travel. Take a quick glance at the platform to ensure all is safe, then unlock the doors. It's time to depart. Set the doors to locked. When fully releasing the brakes, wait until the brake cylinder gauge has stopped moving before applying the throttle. When using the throttle to increase power, do so slowly to provide a comfortable ride for passengers. Use the throttle and brake levers to ensure the line speed limit is adhered to. With passengers boarded, proceed to the next station. Be aware that before arriving there, an emergency stop will be simulated. To recover from this situation, the controls must first be reset. Follow the indicated steps. The train is ready to move again. Continue on to the next station. Practice makes perfect. take a quick glance at the platform to ensure all is safe, then unlock the doors. Good work. That concludes this introduction. More details on the operation of this train can be found in the manual.